Hi, Tamers. Today, we'll be talking about Akronox. They're a really interesting TEM with high damage potential, great utility, and a unique playstyle that sets them apart from other TEMs. There's a lot to cover in this video, so let's jump right into it. Akronox is an Earth and Toxic type TEM, a unique typing. Their first trait is Cobweb, which applies the trap status for 2 turns to any TEM that Akronox poisons, or any TEM that Akronox attacks that's already poisoned. Being able to apply the trap status on the fly gives Akronox some great utility. Akronox's second trait is Book Lungs, which reduces incoming water damage by 50%. This trait is also good, especially if the opponent is expecting you to have Cobweb and tries to knock out Akronox with a neutral damage water move. I think Cobweb is usually better overall, because I'd imagine most water TEMs don't want to stay in against Akronox in the first place, and the trap utility is more valuable more often, but situationally, having resistance to water can be appreciated. I'd say which trait you choose depends on your team comp, namely how the rest of your team deals with water. With trait covered, let's move on to Akronox's moveset. Their signature move is Sting. This is a low damage but high priority technique that applies poison for 2 turns. This is unfortunately Akronox's only technique that applies poison, which in turn is Akronox's only way of trapping TEMs with the Cobweb trait on its own. The most important thing about Sting is it synergizes with Akronox's strongest technique, Venom Spread. This technique is also high priority and has a whopping 150 base power, but it only damages TEMs if they have the poison condition. A lot of Akronox's power comes from this technique, so we'll need to utilize it to get the most out of our Scorpion friend. Akronox also learns Toxin Shower, which after patch 7.4 gives Akronox a much appreciated evasion option. So Akronox learns some pretty decent toxic techniques. What about their earth techniques? Akronox gets Mud Shower and Earth Wave. This is unfortunately Akronox's biggest flaw, as Mud Shower has below average base power, but at least it's a special technique. And Earth Wave is great, but it's a physical technique which has anti-synergy with whatever special Venom Spread build we go for, not to mention its 2-hold. This problem would be completely solved if Akronox could learn Soil Steam. I mean, the description of the technique literally mentions the Tossa Desert, and Akronox is found in the Tossa Desert. Same thing with Drakash. Crema, explain. The way I see it, there are only 2 options. Give Akronox and Drakash Soil Steam, or change the name and description of Soil Steam, because I don't see why Gario, the cold and wet salamander, gets Soil Steam and the actual desert TEMs don't. My immersion is being ruined, Crema, please fix! But yeah, at the time of making this video, Akronox doesn't have great earth moves. Kind of a bummer, but it's not the end of the world. Onto their base stats, which are really well-rounded. Just all around decent everything, but nothing above 71. With their traits, moveset, and stats in mind, I recommend playing Akronox as a fast special attacker or a bulky support. So let's put everything together into a proper build for Akronox. Like I said before, the trait choice is flexible, and it mostly depends on your team. Cobweb is usually better, but Book Lungs can be situationally good as well. For moveset, you gotta run Sting and Venom Spread. Sting isn't amazing, it's physical so it doesn't scale with your special attack, but its damage really comes from the poison ticks and it gives you the trap utility to set up for Venom Spread, so you're kinda forced to run it. And Venom Spread gives you the most damage potential. Mud Shower is basically your only option for an Earth Stab move, and although its base power is low, with enough special attack investment you can still threaten most TEMs weak to Earth with a 2-hit KO. And for your 4th slot, Toxin Shower is great. Its damage is pretty good for a team-wide move, and it gives you 2 turns of evasion, kinda like a better Bright Beam. It also gives you the option of another special toxic move in your kit with less setup required to use. Great for finishing off TEMs that are low after being Venom Spreaded. A couple other options you could try in Akronox are Toughen if you wanted to play some kind of defensive variant, Metabolize to support a nature-heavy team, and Untangle. Okay, I know what you're thinking. Untangle? That technique is awful! And you're right, but hear me out. Untangle, like Cage, is ultra priority, meaning it goes before any switches. Its intended use is to remove trap on an ally and then switch them out, but on Akronox specifically, if you use it on a TEM that is already poisoned and you're running the Cobweb trait, you can actually trap them with Untangle. Just look at that animation! So yeah, Untangle isn't great, but on Cobweb Akronox, it can function as a single target cage on TEMs that are already poisoned. And since Untangle removes trap, then reapplies it, you can technically infinitely trap a TEM with Sting and Untangle every other turn. I don't know why you would, but how funny would that be if you did? Just food for thought. Okay, let's move on to gear. Iron Coating is okay, although the damage increase isn't that much since Mud Shower base damage isn't the greatest. Reactive Vial seems good too. Survivability is pretty important since Akronox needs to live 2 turns to set up its own Venom Spread. Coat and Double Screen are also pretty good for that. My favorite gear choice, however, is Morale Boosting Whip. Akronox partners best with a Tem that can apply poison faster than Akronox's Venom Spread. And since Akronox's base speed is above average and Venom Spread is high priority, there aren't a ton of Tems that can do it without a good amount of speed investment themselves. The Whip really helps Akronox's partners meet the speed requirement without eating into their TVs. It also helps the other Venom Spreaders, like Cycrox and Chromion, keep up with Akronox's Sting if you're playing multiple Venom Spreaders on the team. With that being said, let's move on to TV spreads. Usually I would just give you a spread that works for everything, but Akronox is pretty partner reliant. You want them to be slower than the Tems on your team that apply poison, and faster than any other Venom Spreaders on your team. That way you can do crazy high damage Venom Spread double-ins, which is where most of the Tems' power comes from. So instead, here's a table showing some example speed investments, potential partner speed investments, and how running Whip on Akronox could affect it. I know this is a lot of information to process, but to summarize, Akronox has a lot of potential partners if you run a slower build, but if you want to play a max speed Akronox, it pretty much only pairs well with Ukama and Mimit. We'll talk more about this in the partner section of the video. So here are 2 sample builds, and you're just gonna have to adjust the speeds of each build to fit whatever partners you want to run with them. Bulky Akronox is a little more well-rounded, since it gives Akronox more potential to Sting and Venom Spread multiple times without dying. And Fast Akronox lets you get off some unstoppably fast Venom Spread one-shots in the early game, but will probably only attack once or twice before dying, but sometimes that's good enough. Bulky Akronox wants 127 stamina TVs, reaching 65 stamina so you can Sting or Venom Spread 4 times without overexerting, and since you'll probably be setting up your own Venom Spreads from time to time, being able to use each technique twice can be useful. Otherwise, run a minimum of 23 stamina TVs, like on the Fast Spread. This reaches 52 stamina, which lets you use Sting or Venom Spread 3 times without overexerting. Both builds put 494 TVs into Special Attack, so you can deal big damage with Venom Spread. Then, adjust your speed according to your team's needs, and then leftover TVs into HP. Instead, if you wanted to play Akronox as some kind of bulky support, with the goal to just trap enemies and survive hits, do pretty much the same thing but prioritize HP over Special Attack. And you could skip Special Attack entirely if you're solely using Akronox as a poison applier for other Venom Spreaders on your team. With builds covered, here are some tips for playing Akronox. Try to predict your opponent's swaps. If your opponent is staring down an Ukama and an Akronox and they have a Tem that resists Toxic in the back, they will usually swap to it, at least until they can figure out how fast your Akronox is. A good Sting prediction can trap the enemy into unfavorable matchups with another Tem on your team. The threat of Venom Spread is almost as good as using Venom Spread, so use that pressure to your advantage to make early game reads and gain tempo. Here are some good partners for Akronox. I've said this a couple times in the video, but just to reiterate, Akronox belongs on a Venom Spread team. So, he pairs best with fast poison appliers and other Venom Spread users, because Akronox themselves is a fast poison applier. Ukama is the premier poison applier with its high base speed and water cannon. Plethoric Ukama takes that to a whole other level, allowing you to play a max speed Akronox if you like. Koish, Two-Wire, and Molgu are great for slower Akronox builds. Koish's Synergy Master gives it a very strong water cannon to soften enemies up to be finished off with Venom Spread, and Two-Wire and Molgu's Faraday Cage deal great damage on the physical side, which also makes for a very powerful double-in with Venom Spread. The only other Venom Spreaders in the game currently are Cycrox and Chromion. Akronox outspeeds them baseline, so they're easy to set up using Sting. And it's worth it because Cycrox and Chromion have higher damage potential with Venom Spread anyway, especially Sinner-typer Chromion, who hits like an absolute truck. But at the same time, don't sleep on Pigment Inverter Chromion. A lot of types resist Toxic, so being able to threaten them on the same team as well can be very useful. In fact, Aloe Vera Toxic Chromion can do surprisingly high damage with Toxic Torrent into Toxic Tems that would otherwise wall your strategy. I should also mention Mimit. They pair really well with Akronox because they either fit the role of a poison applier or a Venom Spreader. Just make sure you know which Tem is faster so you can click Venom Spread on the correct one. Make sure you're running Wind and Electric types to cover against enemy Wind and Toxic Tems respectively, them being the biggest counters to Venom Spread teams. And that's it for Akronox! Their very existence solidifies Venomspread as a viable team archetype, which allows for a fun and rewarding playstyle unlike any other. I hope you give them a try, and I hope you enjoy envenoming the opponent's team to victory. Thanks for watching! My name is Blunk, and I make Temtem content for YouTube. If you like this video, thanks! Stay tuned for more, and have a nice day.